Well, longtime former Fox 40 News anchor Larry Sparano is here to make sense of it all. Hey there, Larry.
Yeah, hi, good morning, Kent. A lot of the stuff with Trump is illogical and nonsense and actually designed to increase the support from conservatives and his base. However, something has to be done. But the problem is, Kent, this is akin to trying to close the barn door after the horses run away.
Mm-hmm.
Because once they started outsourcing these jobs, once NAFTA came into effect, under Clinton, by the way, and trade started going abroad like that, it wasn't a free trading market. It was stacked in favor of U.S. interests to get manufacturing done overseas.
Right.
And it's gotten to such a... Now, in theory, these tariffs long-term may start encouraging the rebuilding of American industry. But in the meantime, what happens? If that is the end effect, even that's questionable. But, this is really no solution.
Right.
And also, what's happening now is the U.S. is now going to alternate sources in the third world, and Vietnam is now coming on strong as a new China. And it's going to be the same thing there, where another Asian country supplying all these goods, replacing China. So, it's a zero-sum game there.
But go ahead. Yeah.
Somebody suggested that the better way of doing this would have been for Trump to slap big taxes on corporations for foreign manufacturing, but give them huge tax breaks for setting up shop in this country. Therefore, it's an incentive for the corporations rather than putting a burden on the American consumers through these tariffs, which we will be paying for.
Right, exactly. We live up here in Roxbury. We're in sort of farm, rural farm country, and it's good for it's going to be good for the farmers. In a very ironic way,
Yeah. It is such a mess, and he is thinking, I believe, that this kind of approach, which was popular in getting them elected, is still going to play out. But, as the consequences start piling up, that horse may not be a winner anymore for him.
Well, the other thing, Chuck Grassley, who is head of the Senate Finance Committee, already came out last night saying that it's a bad idea both politically and economically, and he's saying it might even not be legal to, declare a national emergency and then use his presidential tariff setting powers for that case. So it might be illegal.
Right.
Plus, I don't think he gets he doesn't really get the psychology Trump does of people and countries, in the sense that I can't think of any Mexican politician that would go along with that. Because it's an insult in a way, to the country, to the machismo of the country and that sort of thing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it becomes, a certain type of contest that's attributed between males, if you want to put it in blunt terms.
Yeah, and it's a condescension. It's like, we're going to put this tariff on you and...
But at the same time, Ken, Mexico is not playing fair. They're not doing enough to stop that cross-border migration.
Well, what more could they do? In what sense? How do you mean?
I mean, they could physically stop a lot of this migration. A lot of it's cross-migration coming through their country as well. And, they haven't done much to really stop these caravans.
You mean stop
now, some of it is going to be difficult, to detect, considering the type of border that it is.
Right.
And you can't patrol all of it. But I don't think they've been making some real strong efforts. But, another thing here is that the agriculture industry in those border states, they're welcoming these immigrants, especially ones that cross over. And a lot of them cross over, go back to Mexico, because they're like migrant workers that the agriculture industry heavily depends on.
Right.
So, they could shut this down by merely patrolling companies that employ illegals and fine them. But they're not doing that again because, you lay off the corporations.
Yeah, that's true. All right, sir. Well, listen, have a good weekend and, eat a lot of veggies and fruits before they get too expensive.
Hey, by the way, you were a dairy farmer once.
Yeah, right.
Kind of like a fish out of water walker up there. That's a great story. You should tell your listeners
sometime.
All right.
All right. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.
All right. Bye now.
That was Larry Sparano, longtime Fox 40, former Fox 40 news anchor and an investigative journalist, and he can be seen and heard on his website, which is called On Target with Larry Sparano.